Morning, everyone. This is day two. Heading out to Alabama. This is how low my car is. I mean, it's low. It's crazy. I can feel the top of my van. Ah, I didn't film yesterday. It was beautiful. Time to get on the road again.
Hey, everybody. It's Becky with Vintagevikingtreasures, and this is our booth setup. BTS show. We have linens that people have actually gone through. I'm gonna back it up just a little bit. I'm gonna show you. We have 8 8-foot tables all the way down to the end down there. We have a 6 foot out, and then we have 6 foots all the way back here, and a 6 foot table right here on the end. There's four of us that went together to make this mega booth here at the beautiful Table Settings Bash convention. And we basically each had 2 8-foot tables on the back wall and then the corresponding tables on the front. Some of our things were mixed together a little bit depending on what kind of items they were, if they went together color-wise. Barb is down on this end, and I'll go back on the front side after we go down the whole back wall. And this is my section, starting here at the boxes down to that blue box right in there. I did a lot of salads and bread and butter kind of plates because I know a lot of the table settings people like to have the stacks of plates and have a fun printed plate for the top to coordinate for a theme. We do have a few holes, like here and there. We are on our last day. They did two 2.5-day conventions in a row. And then the last day here on Saturday is open to the public. This started Steven's section. You see him once a month on my pop-up, or excuse me, my live sales. And this is him over here. There he is. He's doing his own video.
We're doing our own video.
And then John Walks continues down here. And he has a whole... This is a little bit different setup for him because usually we see the majority of his Fenton and other glassware. So it's a lot of china and potteryware for him. You want to say hi?
Hello.
There he is. He's got a lot of silver and a whole table right here that was set up for it today. This is a very popular section for him this time around. He also has some books right here on that section. Now, the front section goes all the way back down there. It's set with a riser down the middle, so we have stuff on each side of those shelves. He's got elegant glass as well on this side. This is Stevens. Again, this is some Russell Wright. We brought things for centerpieces, displays, vases. A lot that people like to do coordinating themes. These are fake lemon slices. They've been popular for bowl filler. And then we are back to my section of the front table, and it runs down here into Barb's. Some Ruby, Fustori American, some Fenton, cake plates, banana boats, sterling, I think a sterling, silver plate probably, with a peacock etched on that teapot. Some of the highlights of the booth. We have Fenton mixed in because we thought it would be good for coordinating with colors and centered displays. Lots of fun colors in stemware and glasses to coordinate with dishes as well. And now the inside. We do like to do fun things like this with stacking the stands to have some fun displays. There's some glowy glass, that is stretch, in the topaz color. There's a little bit of silverware down here, a little bit of linens, had some flower frogs, and the end of it will come back down to the back side of the tables here. We did a little section of hall and a few different patterns and colorways. Stephen brought some hankies to fill in, a little bit of Disney, and Winnie the Pooh, and then ending up again with John's down here. So that's it. Our big mega booth all the way down. It's been fun, but it's been a long week. So I'll try and get some more to put with this for a video a little later. See y'all soon. Steven and everyone else wants to know what the bins, like the Amazon bins, are like. I'm pretty much standing in the middle, and they have all these bins all the way around. They load them up with stuff. Everybody goes through them. When they start to get a little empty, they totally dump one bin into the other, and you just fill up a cart, like this. I've done a little bit of an adventure. I am at flea market in Canton, Texas, and walking around a while. Took in a few of the indoor buildings, found a few treasures, and I'm half tempted to try out one of those scooters at this point, but I think I'm going to be calling it for the afternoon and call myself lucky to have not gotten sunburned or a heat stroke. It's a beautiful day, so it's been really kind of fun. I was trying to see about catching some more of the scooters, but I'll try again. A lot of scooters. We got scooters and wagons as far as the eye can see. They rent them, which is amazing. And then everybody, a lot of people bring their own wagons. But then they make trains out of them. They have two-seat stand-up scooters. They got a double with somebody to ride on in the back. They take the wagons and they bungee a wagon to the back and pull that along with them as well. So it's way easier to get around, I guess, when you got your scooters. However, it is much harder to walk around them and get through the crowd, especially as a pedestrian. It's been fun though. Found some treasures. Just sitting here waiting for the tram. And go back out to find the car. It's really funny because they had one of the scooters with a trailer on it that they loaded up another scooter on. Just drove right past me. There's one sitting there waiting for somebody. And took it back to the recharging station, I'm sure. Look at all the campers out here. Here's the tram. Here's my ride. One of them scooters. Scooter with a wagon. We're just hanging out. We're gonna find the car. Alright, I'm leaving before it blows away. It was fun, Canton. Try making it, guys. It's Becky. I've been trying to kill some time until dinner, checking out a few of the local malls. This one is mostly, I'd say, t-shirts, crafts, lots of that stuff, but yeah, I'm just taking my little vase for a walk through the rest of the mall. See if we can find anything else good, because if there's one, we can only hope that there's more. I mean, I appreciate a good gnome as much as the next, but you can't go from one booth to the next without finding another gnome everywhere. After that tan bag is out, this is what came back with me from the show. all those boxes. Deep, deep. So this is 6 banana boxes. So 2 deep, 2 high, 3 across. And then all the boxes on top of that. And then on this side, boxes and tubs, and there's 4 banana boxes in there on the floor. And then shelves, 3 layers deep here. And I'll show you a quick video of what we just took out. So when I left to go to the show, all the space I had was a spot right here for my suitcase and my bag. And then all the rest of this was boxes to the ceiling. So some shallower boxes were stacked too high. So basically right now I only have 3 layers, 3 layers deep came home, but 4 to 5 layers went out with me. And I had Paula's stuff down here on the floor underneath my snack box. So yeah, that's basically where it's at. We're gonna stop here for tonight. Tomorrow we can probably do some more unloading, and I'll show you how we'll put it out on the porch so you can see all that came out and how it's in there, but how it looks before it gets packed in there. Okay, guys. These 2 boxes came from Paula. I took her 3. She gave me back 2. Those 2 came out of the car. These 2 I just showed you. Those 2 banana boxes came off the top layer. This is just empty to redo. This is a box top of bananas. That's all the random things that I bought along the way that were just in bags. This is a bag from the dollar store. That's a quilt I got. And here's the stack of gnomes from the dollar store. All this right here and that one there when I was in Florida. And a picture Steven sent home with me. And that black bag. And that black box. And that box right there on top too. So I think that's what we've all unpacked so far.
The quilt, but moved these 2 next to it. And then there were 2 underneath the quilt that I forgot about. So there's more.
Hi guys. It's a beautiful day. We're unloading the van. Okay. This stack here, and this, that is all mom stuff that is either going back to mom or going to the booth eventually. We left some in the van, including enough shelves here and here for our Springfield show. So those are the cores for standing the shelves up. And then these are, 8 boxes that we're leaving in the van that will go to that Springfield show, because that'll just be packing in about 1.5 weeks. This is what's coming out. 1, 2, a little bitty box, 3, 4, those are going to my booth. These are the BTS boxes that are going into storage in the garage. So there's 4, 8, 9. That's going to the booth later, that's 10. That's a tub of linens that will need to go to the booth later. 2 racks. All those shelves, about 12 more shelves came out. These 2 are mid-mod. That's where they're being organized to. And this stack right here is what's going in the house. And the majority of what that is a couple things that are too delicate for outside. And empty boxes just full of wrap. So this is everything that came out of the van. And we gotta load some back up, because we had to organize it for where it's going. And yeah, so it doesn't look nearly as much stuff when it's out. Well, maybe it's the other way around. It looks like more stuff to me when it's out, I guess, than when it's in. So that is how I packed for BTS. And yes, we still have a little bit of snow from the other day, but it's supposed to be 80 soon. So see y'all soon. Bye-bye.